Ever to go, goal scorer, number 8, Ola Mangala!
Welcome to Trophy TV, it is the match reaction. Everton 4, Wolves 0. Well, well, well. What you can achieve when you actually attack. Listen, a unexpected scoreline. Not an unexpected result. I did fancy Everton today. I took a little bit of, not a little bit of stick, but people were questioning why I was confident we'd win today. Because basically, like I've maintained all season, this team are far better than it's shown. And tonight, Everton scored 4. And in all reality, could have scored 8. They had 2 goals disallowed. Jack Harrison's missed 2 really good opportunities. We've had other chances as well. And we were comfortable in the game. And Wolves, listen, their fans were fantastic all night. I have to say that. Brilliant support from them. But I'd be a bit worried if I was them, because defensively, they are all over the place. I think they knocked the ball around nicely. They got good attacking players. But defensively, you're in big trouble if you defend the way they currently defend. And Everton took full advantage of it. The manager went with Mangala in midfield, which I thought was the right decision, to play him with Idrissa Garner-Gay. He started with Abdoulaye Doucouré in the 10. He took out Jesper Lindstrom. He had Ndiaye on the right, McNeil on the left. And Everton started okay. I mean, Wolves had a really good move early on and Strand Larsen couldn't wrap his foot around it. He got to the byline, cut it back. And if he'd have been able to get a good connection on it, we might have been in a little bit of trouble, but he didn't. And then it was a good run by Cunha, forced a save from Jordan Pickford. Yes, it was one you'd expect Pickford to save, but still, he still had to do it. And Everton, we're knocking it round okay, but weren't able to create anything of any note, really. Again, the final ball with us sometimes is just the wrong option. We make the wrong choice with the pass, or players aren't confident enough to get shots away. But we did take the lead. And it was, you know what, if I'm a Wolves player, I might be slightly aggrieved, and a few of them were, the way that the referee played an advantage and then brought it back, even though Doucouré was offside. Calvert-Lewin did really well. Nick Dean was taken out. He was fouled. The referee played on. The ball arrived at Doucouré's foot. He smashed it way over the bar into the park end. The linesman put his flag up, but the referee brought it back and gave Everton the free kick. And obviously from that, Ashley Young curled in a free kick. I'm screaming, just hit the target. He did. He put it beyond Jose Sa. And it was the first goal scored at Goodison from a free kick by an Everton player in the Premier League since Luca Dean in 2018. And I think that was December as well. He equalised in the 96th minute, I think it was, against Watford at the street end. Ben Foster just watched it going. But it was a good free kick from Young and gave Everton the lead. And that sort of galvanised us, kicked us up a little bit of a gear. We sort of were a little bit quicker to things then. Wolves were looking frail at the back. We thought we had a second goal. Free kick from Dwight McNeil. Bent it in. James Tarkowski headed it in. And it went to VAR. And they took an age. And the referee went to the screen to rule it out for an offside. Now, I don't understand. Mangala is blocking Lamina, I believe. Mangala's offside. So just tell the referee it's offside. I didn't understand why he had to go to the board or the screen to look at it. I understand if you were giving it for an infringement, for a foul, the referee might want to go and check it. But it's being disallowed because Mangala's offside. So I just didn't get that. I really didn't get it. And, you know, the Wolves fans, I thought they were brilliant. They were singing things like, "This isn't football," and, you know, the usual, you know, fuck VAR and all that. Wolves then had a good chance. The throw-in, Everton should have defended it well, and Strand Larsen got a shot away. Jordan Pickford parried it out to keep Everton ahead. And then we did get a second goal. And Mangala, who I thought was brilliant all night, wrapped the ball home to make it 2-0 at the Park End. And that Everton were in total control, and Dwight McNeil sent, I don't think he had a great game, Dwight, to be fair, when he looks back at it. I think it wasn't one of his better games, shall we say. But he hit a great shot with his left foot, and Lamina's had to stick his head up and deflect it wide. Otherwise, that would have been 3-0 before half-time. And they just looked, really, like I said before, frail at the back. Everton were getting in, Dom. So Calvert-Lewin worked hard, and he's sort of in that thing of he can't buy a goal at the moment. Put himself about tonight, though. Good running, good hold-up play. Made a nuisance of himself. But we went in 2-0 at the break, and I did think that they'll come out really lively at the second half, and we've got to be careful. And they come out and they got a corner straight away, and then James Tarkowski's got a really important header in, and they had a couple of things that had flashed across the goal. He did in the first half, though, as he put two across brilliantly, which Stan Larsson almost turned in. But Everton then went broke and got a third goal. A ball into the box, forced the corner. The corner came in, Calvert-Lewin jumped for it with others. It's gone in. We all thought it was Dom's goal at first. It was Craig Dawson, own goal, to make it 3-0, and that really was. It was game over. Then Wolves didn't have anything, really, after that. Cunha was trying. He's clearly their best footballer. So graceful, great first touch. And Everton, it was comfortable. We had a fourth goal disallowed, and correctly so. It was Dom challenged Saar, and he dropped the ball, and Illiman and Jai knocked it in. But that was ruled out as well. And then we did get a fourth goal, and it was, again, people thought it was Dom. I did say, was it an own goal? But they give it to Calvert-Lewin, but it has been given as an own goal. Dwight McNeil curled the ball in. And Dom, just his reaction, went for a diving header. I think, I've not seen it again, by the way. But I'm thinking he's flicked it and it's hit Dawson and gone in. But just by Dom's reaction, I was thinking, doesn't look like he's actually scored it. But it ended up in the net and it was 4-0. And it was at that point, it was comfortable. I think the manager should have made subs earlier. I do. I believe that. But, you know, he brought Jack Harrison on. He did make that change, brought Jack Harrison on as well. And Lindstrom came on. We got to see Armando Breuer, who I thought was really lively. Looked quite promising. Couple of great runs, laid two on a play for Jack Harrison, which he skied both of them. Got in behind, lovely first touch control, strong. I think he'll be a real asset. We got to see Harrison Armstrong, who managed to pick up a booking with a slide tackle. Kept the clean sheet. Good night's work for Jordan Pickford. Thought Tarkowski had his best game for a while. Ashley Young, I thought, was excellent as well tonight. Drissa Garner-Gay, brilliant. And it was a thoroughly enjoyable and well-deserved victory for Everton tonight. So well done, Sean Dyche. Well done, everyone concerned with that tonight. We've got a huge game at the weekend. This was a massive game for Everton tonight. They had to win it. There couldn't have been any other result, really. We had to win it. We've had an 8-goal swing on Wolves tonight, which is welcomed after shipping 4 goals on Sunday. There's the next 4 are not great fixtures. Liverpool, Arsenal away, Chelsea home, City away. We could well lose all 4 of them, but you know what? We go into the derby with a bit of renewed confidence. They've only drawn tonight at Newcastle. Just seeing the Newcastle equaliser, the third goal. Everton are strong off set pieces. And Newcastle have got a goal off that. So that's what we should be working on for the weekend. But that's for a different day. That's for Friday to think about that. This tonight is for enjoying this. Gary O'Neill, I think, is on borrowed time at Wolves as well. I think their fans made their feelings quite clear to him. They do play nice footy, but they can't defend like that because they're going to have a real uphill struggle. But for us, it's a 5-point gap. Like I said, an 8-goal swing on Wolves, and that's a huge thing tonight. My man of the match, I'm going to give it to Oro Mangala. Got a goal. I thought he was excellent. He was everywhere. Got a standing ovation when he left the pitch. Him and Idrissa Garner-Gay, they're the midfield too. Shouldn't be broken up for now. It'd be great when Irabunum and James Garner are back and you've got some options to play with there. But them two, for me, right now are the best partnership. Drissa was brilliant, but Mangala is my man of the match. Great win. Delighted. If you'd a trophy, enjoy it. Enjoy the next few days before the derby. Just bask in this. It's our third win of the season. It's only our second home, and you know, we, the last one we won was in September. So this was a big win. It was a team who were around us. Tonight sort of just reaffirmed my belief that this team and squad is way better than it showed. So they all have to step up to the plate. The players and the manager have set the target now. Go and reproduce it. Simple as that. But listen, tonight's a brilliant result. We should all enjoy it and smile. So for that, make sure you like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. See you later.